Hey guys, welcome back. I know it's been a while, and as you can probably tell from my unkempt appearance, this is not going to be a beauty video. In fact, if you notice, I haven't been on YouTube for a while, and it's because, to be honest with you, I don't really feel motivated anymore to talk about beauty and makeup. Well, beauty, yes. Makeup, not so much, because like I told you guys before, I'm trying to be a little bit more minimal, keeping what I need. I've downsized my collection. I haven't been buying very much makeup anyways, and I feel like there's already so many YouTubers out there who talk about the new releases in makeup or reviews and stuff like that, that perhaps my opinion is not as important. But I'm sorry I look like this. I just got back from the Philippines. I flew in at lunchtime today. I didn't really have much of sleep on the plane. So this is it. What I'm going to be talking to you guys about, though, is the ketogenic diet. And, well, this video is going to be, as you can probably tell from the title, is that it's going to be a food shop for keto. I've been on and off of keto for about a year and a half now. And truth be told, the last couple of months, maybe last 2 months, I've been pretty slack. So I'm trying to get back on track, and we'll be doing strict keto from tomorrow, which is Monday the 6th of August. Today's the 5th. Yeah, so there is one non-keto food here. And when I say non-keto, I'm not saying that there's a list of food that you can or cannot eat on keto. It's actually more on what I follow, the what fits in your macro principle, wherein as long as I keep it under 20 grams, regardless of carbohydrates, regardless of where that carbs come from, to me it doesn't matter. And that one thing that isn't carb-friendly, isn't keto-friendly, is this pack of mandarins. Now, this has got about 5 grams of carbs in each one of these mandarins. But like I said, I subscribe to the if it fits your macro information or principle, then I could actually eat 4 of these in a day. And I would rather get my sugar from natural sources than from artificial ones. So, because fruits have fructose, which is a form of sugar. So there you go. But yeah, one a day is probably okay. Another one, still fruits. These are strawberries. Berries are okay on keto as long as you eat them moderately, in moderation. So I got 2 packs of strawberries, which are gonna be good. I'm probably gonna freeze some of these because I won't be eating them in one go anyway. not keto, because these are foot socks. I need a few of them now, so just getting in there. Okay, apple cider vinegar. This is the organic version from Kohl's. This is definitely keto friendly. In fact, you are encouraged to take, I think, a tablespoon each day of apple cider vinegar to, like, sort of, what's the right term, balance your acids in your stomach. So there you go. And it's got a lot of good properties, that one there. Also, I've got 2 friends who are also on keto, which is, like, they inspire me and motivate me to keep at it. And they found, particularly my friend Sheridan, she's actually found 2 condiments, because condiments are loaded with hidden sugar. She found these 2 condiments at the health food aisle of Kohl's. This one is called Sweet Chili Sauce by Celebrate Health. This one is gluten-free, and each serving, which is 20 mils, or about is that a teaspoon? Probs. It's got 1.3 grams of carbohydrates and 0.3 grams of sugar. So that's pretty good for a condiment. And the other one here is tomato sauce from the same brand. This one has got 2.1 grams of carbohydrates, 0.9 grams of which is sugar. So that's pretty good for ketchup or for tomato sauce and sweet chili sauce, because it's much, much higher in other brands. And these were like $3 for this one. It's gonna last me a long time, so I was fine with spending that a little bit more, because obviously regular brands would be cheaper than that. I have here, well, you can't see it, but it's cheese Kransky. I've got 4 pieces of these. I usually like take 2 for lunch. Sometimes one is actually enough, because when you eat a lot of fat, you feel full faster, and for longer you feel satiated quickly, so you don't really have to eat a lot. And I find myself when I'm on street keto that I can go for hours without eating, and then once I regulate my body, it becomes more like I eat when I'm hungry, not because it's time to eat. I've been trained since I was a child to eat breakfast at 7 a.m., lunch at 12 p.m., dinner at 7 p.m. And that's how my body has functioned for a long time. But now that for the last year and a half, I've learned that I don't actually have to eat unless I'm hungry, okay? Because hunger is a sign of your body that you need nourishment, right? And when you have a lot of fat, and especially fat to burn in your body, keto is actually pretty good because it transitions your body from using carbs and sugars as your fuel into using your fat. So especially if you have stored fat and you start burning it, that's how you get lean. Anyways, let's continue. I've got some deli here. It's got prosciutto, Italian salami, and hot chorizo salami. So there you go. I would normally eat this with cheese because cheese is good for you on keto, but in moderation, because some people stall their weight loss when they have dairy. I always have this with blue cheese or brie or camembert. So there, and it's gluten-free, so pretty good. I also started taking soy milk, unsweetened soy milk, because I find that when I take lactose milk, I go to the bathroom too often. So yeah, so I prefer soy milk. Plus it's got less carbs and sugar in here. This one has got carbohydrates, and those all come from sugar. When you get full cream milk here, for some reason it's 12 grams of sugar for every 250 mil, so every glass is 12 grams. So I'm like, what? This one's got 1 gram of carbs. Okay. I've already made it a habit to look at the nutritional information when I buy stuff from the shops. This one is Tasmanian salmon, boneless with the skin on, and I really like this. Fish has a little bit more carbs, or seafood in general has a little bit more carbs, but salmon has really good fatty oils in it that I'm not really bothered. It's got less than 1 gram of carbohydrates per section, so I've got 4 pieces here, and I usually consume 2 of these, sometimes just 1, depending on how I make it. And especially if I make it with vegetables like broccoli and stuff, then I just take 1 because it fills you up really quickly. I've also got some pork spare ribs here. There's 5 pieces in here. Yeah. And I just either pop this in the oven and cook it like that, or I make it into adobo, or there's a few things that you can do with this guy. And then lastly, now this one is a pre-seasoned drumsticks, Australian chicken drumsticks, Tuscan style herbs and garlic. Now, obviously when I buy something that's already got seasoning in them, I actually look at the ingredients and I look at the carb content. So this one has got Tuscan herbs, garlic sprinkle. It's got a little bit of rice flour, so you have carbs in there. Salt, sugar, herbs. But each serving, which is 2 drumsticks, is only 5.7 grams of carbs, which has 1 gram of sugar. And then you've got dietary fiber, which is 1.5. So if you subtract that from the 5.7, you have got 4.2 grams of carbs per 2 drumsticks. So that's not bad at all. And I'll be honest with you, I never know what to do with chicken, so I'd rather get them already pre-seasoned so I know that the seasoning actually works, as opposed to me guessing and then making trial and error and then not loving what I'm cooking. So I got these. I could have 4 meals out of these. So 4 meals out of these. The pork is probably going to give me 3 meals. The salmon is probably going to give me 2 to 3 meals as well. And the Kransky definitely is going to give me at least two meals. So that's me sorted out for the week. Might even end up being sorted out for 2 weeks instead of that. Because really, when I don't eat breakfast, I do intermittent fasting. I don't eat until 11 a.m. And then I don't eat after 7 p.m. So in between those 8 hours, I have lunch and dinner. Depending on what I have for lunch, I don't feel the need to snack in the afternoon. And when I do, it's always going to be like either the berries or the mandarins or some sugar-free protein peanut balls that I made or anything that I can fit into my macros. So what my macros currently are is I've got 5% of my macros as carbs, 25% coming from protein, and the rest, the 70%, is coming from fats. And so far it's been working for me. Now, there's a lot of questions about keto, why I'm doing it. Now, I am not a nutritionist. I'm not a doctor. I just know that it works for me because I've tried it for a while. I've had my blood work done like 3 weeks ago. Everything was pretty good, low risk, nothing. If anything, I feel much healthier being on this. There's a lot of contradicting information about this lifestyle, but so far it's worked for me and I haven't felt like I was missing out on anything. Sometimes I do crave carbs, but I find that if I stick to strict keto for the first 2 weeks, the cravings drop and I don't feel the need to actually eat anything carby. So yeah, there you go. I spent a total of $88.58 Australian dollars. If I deduct the socks, that's about $72 Australian dollars on food alone. But that's probably gonna be like 2 weeks supply of food. And yeah, I think that's pretty good. So let me know in the comment section down below if you have any questions. I'm gonna try and do a little bit more of like an informative video on what keto is, like to try and simplify it, because there's a lot of science behind it. I would also be linking in the description down below a lot of the resources that I use for me to understand better what keto is. And yeah, I'm gonna try and do a before and after photo, but I'll show you that in maybe a month's time, because honestly, I'm not really proud of my shape right now, so I can't. Yeah. So, but anyway, I'll show you guys that in maybe a month to 2 months time, see the progress and how it's doing. I'm also gonna be quitting my gym. Because I feel like I'm spending like $30 a fortnight for the gym and I haven't really been going. Because I find I prefer to be outdoors than confined in a room. And I've also bought some at-home gym equipment that I feel is going to be good enough for me to be able to work out at home as well. Yeah, so that's it. I hope you guys like this video. Like I said, if you have any questions, do leave them in the comment section down below. And I'll try to get back to you as much as I can with the information that's available out there. And I encourage you to do your own research. If you are looking to do this as well, for whatever reason that you have, I suggest that you go see your doctor first. A lot of them probably will admittedly say that it's probably not a good idea because there's still a lot of traditional medicine that's out there that contradicts what keto is. So decide for yourself what's good for your own body by doing your own research. All right, and I'll see you all again in the next video. Just letting you know that you might not be seeing a lot of beauty videos or makeup related videos in the future, just because it's no longer what I'm passionate about. But you will still see me around, hopefully giving you a little bit more information and education on the kind of lifestyle that I'm at right now. That's it. Bye.